Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back. This is part of a blog hoop as we celebrate the May release by Simon Says Stamp, so make sure to visit my blog. You will find there all the details about the giveaways and the rest of the stops on the blog hoop. Now today I will be using three products from the latest release. This is the Picking Daisy die. I will be using this die today to create three different cards in completely different styles, and it's probably one of my favorites from this release. And here is another die set from this release. This is called Rounded Corner Rectangles, and you can see it has rounded corners and seven dies inside. This is one of those essential dies that you will be using again and again for your cards. And here is a big stamp set with many daisies. This is called Daisy Bouquet, and it comes with lots of designs for you to color and as well as many sentiments. For today, I will be using only sentiments from this stamp set. So let's start with my three cards. I am going to secure both these dies, one inside the other, and cut out a little panel. And I absolutely love this detail of the flower peeking out on the window. On the bottom of this panel, I'm going to stamp a sentiment that comes from the Daisy Bouquet stamp set. And I use the sentiment that says celebrating you today. I'm going for an elegant look for this card. I have stamped it with Versamarking and embossed it with white embossing powder. And you can just stick this panel on top of a card base and leave it simple. I decided to go with a shaker card, so I used acetate and a foam tape all around. As my card base, I'm going to use this glitter paper. This is by Tonic Studios. I'm going to add some of my crystal gems inside and then stick that panel on top. I press hard to make sure that I have a nice bonding with that foam tape, and now all I have to do is to stick this panel on a pre-folded standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. Now just because I have these rounded corners on my inside panel, I decided to repeat that look on the outside edges, and that's why I'm using my corner chomper to do that. As a finishing touch, I have a very thin thread which I'm going to thread through that stem and tie a little bow. And finally, I'm going to add a dot of glue at the center of my flower and stick there a little crystal gem. I'm going to call this card done. I love how elegant and simple looking it is, and here is a close-up photo. For the next card, I'm going to die cut three times the flower, and this is going to give me a panel with three windows, and I made sure that I was rotating the die each time so they don't look identical. I am being very careful as I separate everything. This is a very delicate flower and you need to be really careful not to tear it off. Now I have some scrap pieces of cardstock in three different colors, and I'm going kind of a rainbow order here, so yellow, green and blue. I'm going to add all these circles at the back, making sure that I cover up completely all those windows. I stick everything down with my Nouveau Deluxe, just like always, and of course once everything is ready, I'm going to use my scissors and cut out all the excess paper so that my panel is nice and neat. And since I'm going this time for a very colorful and playful card, I'm going to add this on an orange panel. So I have introduced one more color in this color combo. And for some sparkle, I'm going to add clear crystal gems at the center of my flowers. Now all I need to do is to add the sentiment. For that I'm going to use this one, which is from the Daisies Bouquet stamp set, and I'm going to stamp it in different areas with different colors. I tried to find ink pads that match the colors of the cardstock, and of course I need to do some masking so that I don't stamp everything at once. So I stamped the part that says love you with yellow. Now I'm going to stamp the part that says more with green. And finally I'm going to end up the sentiment by stamping the last part that says each day with blue. And there are many different variations for this card. You can also use pattern paper at the back instead of solid color cardstock, or even ink up your own background. For the last card, here is a fun look that looks like a sunset. So I have cut out the die from black cardstock, and I'm going to use some patterned paper at the back. If you don't have such a patterned paper, you can always create your own colored cardstock by using your inks. So I'm going to stick that down. Now, of course, to complete my card, I need a sentiment. For that, I'm going with the same sentiment as I used for the previous card. This time, I'm going to stamp it with Versa marking just below my window. And I'm going to apply two different colors of embossing powder. So I have looked through my stash for colors that match the colors of the pattern paper that I have at the back. And I'm going to try and not make things very neat, so I don't mind if at some point these two embossing powders blend together. But of course you can go for a neater look if you like. Now the embossing powders that I am using are quite chunky, and also the black cardstock that I'm using has a weave on top of it, which means that I will not end up with a super smooth look on my letters, but I really embrace that and I absolutely love the texture and the look that I got. And just for some fun, I'm going to stick that kind of offset on top of an orange panel. And here are some close-up photos on the last card for today. So I hope you had fun and you got inspired to create different looks with just one die that you have on your stash. Don't forget, this is part of a blog hop, so make sure to visit my blog. You will find there all the details about the giveaways. I hope you will all have a lovely weekend, and I'll see you all next week.